Hello everyone, it's Tanya Gabrielle here, Wealth Astrometrologist. Welcome to Star Codes, where today we are going to dive into the Sagittarius New Moon Solar Eclipse. So exciting, happening on December 14th at 4:16 p.m. Universal Time. That is 11:16 a.m. New York and 8:16 a.m. Pacific Time LA. Now, this Sagittarius new moon is so exciting. There's such a beautiful message that is coming through for all of us. This is not just for Sagittarians or for people with moons in Sagittarius or with your natal ascendant in Sagittarius. It's really for all of us because we all have Sagittarius in our natal chart. So this new moon is happening somewhere in your chart and it's an eclipse. So it's going to have a 6-month impact. And that's really good news because this new moon has such a wonderful message. Sagittarius, the symbol is the archer with an arrow and a bow, holding the bow. And the bow is leading us to higher truths, to higher learning, to beliefs that come from a place of love and wisdom. So divine truth. And so it symbolizes the unquenching thirst for knowledge and wisdom. And so Sagittarius expands horizons because as you acquire this wisdom and acquire this knowledge, your understanding expands. And so this is a very beautiful sign of fortunate, positive enhancement. And under Sagittarius influence, you want to know the meaning of life and also give meaning to your own life. And that means the wisdom that you receive is ever expanding. And it's really a quest for eternal truth. It's a quest for justice. So Sagittarius is enthusiastic by nature. It's very passionate. It's a fire sign. And Mars plays a big role as well. And we're going to look at that as well. Mars is a fire planet. So Sagittarius is adaptable by nature. It's resilient. It has Jupiter as its ruling planet, which is enhancing, making things bigger. It's the biggest planet in our solar system. So it enhances joy. It pretty much expands everything that you focus on. And it governs fortunate outcomes because there is a positivity that is infectious with Jupiter. Jupiter, the planet of joy. So Sagittarius teaches us to trust when we feel that inner happiness, when we feel free, and when we're able to laugh at life, to trust the natural process of the ebb and flow of life. So trust is a big theme with Sagittarius. So what we're going to cover is what is going on during this eclipse? The impact of Mercury's powerful conjunction with the Sun and Moon during the eclipse, which has a huge impact on our thoughts and our beliefs, which is Mercury's realm, and beliefs is Sagittarius's realm. Mars's invigorating impact on the Sagittarius New Moon. How Neptune is stirring a passionate awareness and activation of unity consciousness. Neptune governs us all being brothers and sisters, unconditional love. We are all one. And Neptune forms a very important aspect to this eclipse. And then the beautiful connection between Venus and Jupiter that happens as well. So new moons always begin a new cycle. And this is an eclipse, so it's beginning a new 6-month cycle. And Sagittarius is going to signify the new meaning for the new age because we are entering the new age of Aquarius by the end of this year. And so this is really the eclipse preceding. It's a week before that big event on December 21st, the solstice. So it is showing us a new side of Sagittarius, which is about the fountain of wisdom that is within us, that is always available to us. And this stage of consciousness, which is heaven as a reflection of God's consciousness, is also described by the universal month number in December, which is 7. December 2020 adds up to 7. And 7 is the horizontal line at the top, and then the diagonal line coming down, signifying heaven being brought to earth through inspiration, in spirit. So very spiritual number, a number of higher learning, of analysis, of introspection, research. And so God is expressing his, her consciousness through that understanding, that inspiration, that then turns into creation, because we are all creators. We are all divine creators. So you're able to reflect and ponder with this number 7 and with this Sagittarius impact and the Neptune impact as well. You're able to ponder the great mysteries of life, the mystery of God, mystery of source. And so then compassion and deep devotion to love are being taken to a new level at this time. And paradoxically, this is happening by experiencing the opposite of love and unity. So the value of love is enhanced when we really feel the opposite. We feel love a lot more when we see the opposite expression of love. And Sagittarius is enhancing our experiences of love and joy. And so you see the importance of love, unity, consciousness, embracing all as being one big family. You see that more than ever now, and you don't need to be impacted by negativity. And that's really the big message here with the joy that Sagittarius is bringing through. Now, the sun and moon are at 23 degrees in Sagittarius, and 23 is the number of the royal star, the lion. It's the strongest number in numerology, the lion being the king of the jungle. So this is very much about empowerment through joy. And I love this number because in the full moons that we're having right now, they're all at 8 degrees, right? So 8 is another number of empowerment. It's the infinity number. So we have a lot of courage and leadership and confidence and empowerment that is ringing through in the codes of the lunations in the last few months of the year. So as I mentioned, the moon and sun are conjunct Mercury, the messenger, mind, thoughts, communication. And so you have many ideas. You are synchronizing heart and mind with the moon and Mercury coming together, and the light of your soul with the sun and Mercury coming together. And so this is really about your ideas and thoughts getting to a higher level, moving very quickly. And the communication that you have can be very, very positive. Now, Mercury's conjunction with this eclipse is placing a major focus on thoughts and what they are and the impact of thoughts on forging our beliefs. So if you move back and stand back from believing in the voices in your head, which create your thoughts, you are no longer affected by them. So this new moon with this eclipse is basically eclipsing Mercury. It's not only eclipsing the sun, it's eclipsing Mercury. And so they're coming together as one, and it's basically transcending the duality. So when we look at the night sky, for example, we see the stars. And so the darkness is revealing the light. So we don't have to be afraid of seeing the darkness. We just have to be aware of it. The fear of it is going to, you know, create more of the same, because we are attracting a misunderstanding of what's going on by being afraid of it. But if we just are aware that there is darkness in order to reveal the light, then we are in unity with darkness and light. We are literally understanding that the duality is there to enhance and reveal the other. So the same goes with your thoughts. So to the extent that you can see the truth about negative thinking and negativity, you can transcend duality because you are aware of it. But very often we're not. We're actually participating in the illusion because we haven't actually acknowledged it, been aware of it. Now, Neptune is creating a square to the sun and moon. And Neptune in Pisces is reminding you that the negativity in your mind represents an egoic way of thinking. That is not true, because the shadow side of Neptune is illusion, delusion. It literally is casting a shadow, so you cannot see. It is a mirage. So think of it, the Neptune square, as a reminder that we create the mirage of negative thinking, and that that is now coming to light. So see it as a mirage, not as truth. See it as a creation of the ego, which is separated from truth and can only live through the illusion, live through the false story that we create. The only truth is that love is the only reality. And all there is positive expansion, which is what Sagittarius symbolizes. Negativity is just pointing out the absence of love, just like darkness points out the absence of light. So when we go into this moon square Neptune, sun square Neptune, it makes us more open and impressionable, and it calls for a need to just step back, because Neptune wants us to really take the time and get into the silence to understand what our thoughts are actually doing. Remember that Mercury is totally merged with the sun and moon for this eclipse, and Neptune's coming in and saying, okay, it's time to look at the illusion, because this is a square, and the square is really calling you to action. So negativity, just like positivity, can be very magnetic. It can pull you in. And the programming of negativity is rooted in fear programming. It is reinforced by negative entities. They can be physical, they can be non-physical, and they just don't believe meaning a thought pattern that was created through programming, they don't believe in love. This energy doesn't believe in love. And that's because they themselves took on this programming from others who told them that love does not exist, or that love is dangerous. So they believe that moving towards the light is to their detriment. And they believe that moving towards love will end their life. So it is actually the opposite of truth, which, you know, this becomes their reality, though. So because they've created these ideas, which have turned into these beliefs. And so in order for us to clearly see the truth, we are now confronted by this negativity. And it is up to us to see the difference between the false egoic mind, which is full of beliefs about whatever was programmed into the mind in order to separate it from love, to see the difference between that and truth. So if you believe that love does not exist, you believe that programming, then that, of course, becomes your reality. Then you're going to hang and associate with others who also believe as you do. And it reinforces that reality for you. And that reality, you know, becomes your truth. And so the reality always proves to you what you believe to be true. And that's the key here. It doesn't mean that it is. It's just that your beliefs have then turned into experiences that your decisions basically have pulled you into an energy that then creates your reality. So if you believe in hell, for example, you will create that version of hell for yourself. If you believe that love is the only reality, and that earth is a visible expression of beauty and love and expression of God, then you will create that heaven on earth. And once you understand negativity for what it is, which is just that it is a misunderstanding that's very deep, then you no longer feed your thoughts with that negativity. That's when the negativity is no longer based on your beliefs. It no longer forms any kind of grounding energy that you can latch onto, because it stops existing. It's no longer part of your reality. And just like when you discover a lie about something, you can't believe it anymore, and you don't put energy into it, and it doesn't have that impact on you, right? Because you've discovered it is a lie. The same thing goes with your beliefs. So if you've removed the power of the lie over you, you've removed your belief in the lie actually existing. And then all that remains is truth, is love, is joy, is peace. And you feel that inner peace. Now, the moon is also trine Mars, and the sun is trine Mars. And Mars, as I said, fire, and Sagittarius is also fire. So you feel very energized, stimulated to act. This Sagittarius new moon eclipse, trine Mars, boosts your confidence, your enthusiasm. It ties into the 23 degrees. It enhances your instinct. It allows you to really trust in those fortunate outcomes, trust in the goodness of the universe. And it helps you yearn for independence, which is beautiful. You know, Mars is very independent, and we're entering the age of independence and freedom, which is the Aquarian age. And so this is a great period to work on enterprising successes and just guard against anything impulsive or impatient, because, you know, Mars can really get very excited and just go for it. And so you want to hold that in check if it bypasses the natural rhythm of timing in your life. Now, the other transit that is very powerful is Mercury, which is conjunct the actual eclipse, is trine to Mars as well. And that is actually exact during the Sagittarius eclipse. So this means that your ability to move into a new way of thinking is enhanced. So looking at those beliefs, watching the thoughts, your mind is infused with energy. Your whole being is infused with energy. So your messaging and your communication and the way you think can be totally revamped now. It's like a rebirth of the mind, a rebirth of your ideas and what you do with them and where you place your passion, where you place that Mars fire energy, right? So it's the instinct merged with the messenger, making it a messenger of the divine, being fired up by that divine wisdom, that fountain of wisdom, allowing that to flow through you. So when we look too at the positivity of this trine, because we have a triple trine, Sun, Moon, and Mercury all trining Mars, this is really wonderful positive energy. Truth is positive. The truth that life is beautiful and expresses the beauty continually, that is positive news. Life is love. That is positive, right? The whole basis of Sagittarius is the quest for truth and wisdom, and the divine nectar of truth is Sagittarius's domain, the arrow pointing to truth. So here's the important thing. As Neptune's square to this eclipse shows, you won't be released from negativity unless you see the truth about it, unless you become aware of it. And so this is your quest for the truth. You need to be curious. You need to ask questions. And that quest is eternal. It never ends. It's always expanding, just like Sagittarius. It is a process. It is a journey. So you have to see through the negativity, the negative thoughts, as they appear one by one. And then Sagittarius helps you with this joyful awareness. This eclipse, which is, you know, giving us some juice for 6 months, is going to help to make you conscious of what you're thinking moment by moment, as each thought captures your attention and you decide what to give attention to. And that will take a lot of dedication and commitment. Now, dedication and commitment is something that we have really honed this year, because Capricorn owns that realm, dedication and commitment. Capricorn has been active all year because of the two stelliums we've had, January, the 500-year event, and right now, the 4,000 year event between Jupiter, Saturn, and Pluto. And that has really ingrained our commitment and dedication. And so they've been integrated in us. We have trained ourselves to move through any kind of power struggles or disempowerment and allow that Capricorn energy to help us step up. So in the same way, we're using that dedication to retrain our mind so that these negative thoughts will show up less and less. We need to be aware of them. And as long as we catch them, they will leave our mind eventually forever. And that is the expansive message of the eclipse. You can eclipse all negative thinking, in other words. You can just remember how thoughts create your beliefs, whether they're true or not, right? Your mind is becoming now more spacious and positive as you quiet your thoughts, because most thoughts can never contain the full truth. It's just not even possible. They leave out so much because you're not using your heart, your intuition, your introspection. And so something that is true never leaves out anything. It is everything. It is never leaves out any part of the truth. It is the whole truth and nothing but the truth. And so a thought can't even go there. It can't encompass that. So imagine, for example, a universal truth like love is the only reality, or life is infused by love. Life is created by love. Those are universal thoughts. This is not something your mind is going to come up with naturally, right? So it's time to create new paradigms for your thoughts. This is a rebirth of how you even treat your mind. Is it your go-to place, right? Is information the true source of joy, or is it inspiration? You can ponder on that. Because for your thoughts to be true, they need to be true always. Because the truth is true forever. You know, most thoughts, if you think about it, they are assumptions, they are desires, they are misunderstandings, old programming, distorted memories, projected fears of the unknown, right? Fear of what's going to happen in the future, incomplete stories, illusions, fabrications. They're not universal truths. So that's what you're partaking in when you focus on the voice that is constantly running in your mind. Sagittarius is the sign of universal truths. The archer holds the bow of truth and seeks the bullseye, the symbol of the third eye, your eye of perception, right? This is your sensory perception organ. It's the most important sense that we have. And the third eye is the eye of truth. And it connects to the light. And isn't it interesting that it is also part of the head? So we have the voice in the mind that gives voice to many, many illusions that create beliefs. And this is where all the pain and suffering comes from. All these assumptions that are created with the voice. The voice identifies with them and then creates beliefs. And then the beliefs start spinning in our head. And it's, you know, it's a mess. And when that voice is stilled through meditation, through introspection, through silence, then there is no more separation from truth. All that is left, actually, is truth, is love, is peace, is joy. And truth cannot create pain. It may seem that way, but the pain is only the resistance to what actually will set you free. So joy, love, truth, peace cannot create suffering. They're in total balance with the divine. They are neutral. And truth is always positive. Love is always positive. Just like Sagittarius represents that bow of truth that ignites the divine wisdom and leads to enlightenment, life is a school. We need to see it that way. It is a positive experience. Because you are an eternal student of life. You never stop growing. We are all always expanding, right? Sagittarius represents that expansion. Always learning, always evolving. And this is the core message of this Sagittarius solar eclipse, the eclipse right before we move into the Aquarian age. Because December 14th, 14 is the scribe. That's what the ancients described the number as. And the scribe is the person in olden times who hand wrote the wisdom in books, right? It was all handwritten. So the scribe had a very powerful position. Well, that's now turned into media, publishing, communication. And so as you hear stories emerge at this time in the media, use your third eye to scan for the truth and turn to books of wisdom, and also, of course, go within you. You are the eternal scribe of truth. Learn to question things. Be curious, be open, seek always the total full story. So don't be afraid of asking questions and getting facts, because the questioning will always bring you closer to the truth, and truth is always good. So joy is always good. So release those ideas about how things should be, or those beliefs about what you thought was the case, when they don't serve you. When you've come up with something that is untrue, it will imprison you if you don't let it go. It will confuse you. It will create suffering. It will create inner turmoil. It will create separation from others, and of course from God, from Source. So you can unlock yourself from that prison of your own making at any time, because it is of your own making. So seek to be free. Have the inquisitive mind of the eternal student, because freedom is the call for the new age, being free of dogma, being free of the paradigms that have been imposed on us for centuries, millennia. And we're transcending that attachment to belong to a certain belief system that is incorporated through groups or cultures. We're learning to transcend those attachments to thoughts by seeking only what brings us joy, what brings us love. And once we see that most of our thoughts are not based on love, on joy, then we'll stop being interested in what we're thinking, right? So you don't have to feel that addiction, that magnetic pull anymore. Instead, you go from being motivated from your beliefs and thoughts, you get motivated by love and joy. Big, big difference. So your mind contains no real wisdom, divine guidance, intuitive insights. It's not contained there. It comes through inspiration. It comes through your heart and your third eye, your divine intelligence, the intelligence of the heart. So turn to that divine presence for nourishment. And since what you think affects what you feel and what you experience and eventually what you become, choose to think thoughts that help you become your highest version of yourself, the divine self, right? You are designed to be only an expression of light and joy and love, goodness. You are awakening that divine within you right now through this Sagittarius eclipse, and it will counteract the programming with truth, the bow and arrow of truth. You will intuitively focus your mind on truth. You are reprogramming your conscious mind. You're transmuting the voice in your head. And over time, those negative beliefs about yourself and the world are going to be released one by one, as long as you remain aware, right? So the more time you spend in a peaceful state, the less likely you'll return to that pain and suffering that's aligned with the voice running in your head, which is all the old programming based on the past. So you are drinking now from the fountain of wisdom. You've discovered a whole new way of being. And the way you understand and know, have a knowing that you are in the presence of God, is when you feel vibrant, joyful, sparkly, engaged, alive, wonderful, beautiful. This is the state of bringing heaven to earth, that number 7 for December, right? You have fun, you play, you enjoy. You take things lightly. You don't leave any footprints. You leave the world a better place. You leave the day a better place. You leave any situation you engage with in a better place. You know, children feel this naturally when they play. They're just uninhibited. They're just joyful, being in the moment, just living with pure spiritual enrichment and non-judgment, just being creative. So this is truly a time of awakening. The Sagittarius eclipse is so welcomed, so wonderful. 23 degrees, royal star of the lion, just amazing, amazing code. And 23 reduces to 5, 14th of December reduces to 5. This is about setting us free. This is truly the freedom eclipse. This is the incredible moment that we've been waiting for. Setting ourselves free. Only you can do that. Only I can do that. Nobody can do it for you. and to help you understand more of what this whole awakening is about, I've created a free webinar for you, VenusMarsCode.com, that goes into the balancing of these sacred energies and explains the incredible codes, including the number 13, the letter M, the letter V, what they actually mean for Mars and Venus, what they align with, and why every one of us, male and female, is undergoing this shift into supreme balance within each one of us at this time. So go to VenusMarsCode.com, enjoy that free masterclass, have an incredible week, a magnificent Sagittarius solar eclipse, and I so look forward to seeing you next week for our Star Codes podcast. Lots of love, and bye-bye for now.